Hi guys and welcome back to yet another episode ya hapa kwa mheshimiwa Bendawa. Continue subscribing guys, continue sharing our contents. Wakili Maina Kamunya,
yes,
good
sir.
Evening sir.
I'm good, how are you?
I'm doing well.
Kimi niko salama.
Hi.
We are doing fine, thank God for this far.
It has been a minute. Umekuwa wapi? Umekuwa ukifanya nini? What have you been up to?
Tuko tu, tunajaribu kufanya biashara hapa na pale, kazi hapa na pale. To make sure at the end of it all, we maintain employment, we continue to employ others, and we pay tax so that eventually all of us, our country can grow. So, hivyo tumeshikana kidogo kidogo tu.
Santi sana, karibu sana hapa. Wafuasi wangu wanakupenda sana.
Nashukuru.
Wanasemaga uko na wisdom yenye wanataka kusifon kila wakati, kila uchao. Wengi wanasema wameview video zako mara bilibili.
Ah, thank you very much. I love you and I salute you so much. Ni Mungu. Yes.
Wasalimia kwanza, ujiintroduce better. Maybe kuna mtu amekuona for the first time. Hajaipatana na wewe. Mwambie unafanya nini. Maybe na... Yeah, salimia.
Okay.
Nakushikia.
Alright. So, wafuasi wa Mheshimiwa Bendawa. My name is Maina Kamunya. I'm a lawyer by profession. I'm a businessman. I'm a politician. And I'm also a family man. And... I thank you all for loving our shows, for following us. And also, as Mheshimiwa amesema hapa, mnaochingi video zangu marambili. I always will try to give the best so that at least all of us will get informed so that we make the right decision. So, karibuni sana to this episode and make sure that you continue to subscribe and share these videos for many of us to view and also understand what is the current affairs that are going. So, thank you very much. Karibuni sana.
Yeah, karibuni sana guys. So the main reason why I've decided to look for you ni tunasikia kuna division kati ya deputy president na president mwenyewe. Reason being Mheshimiwa William Samoei Ruto, who is our president, alionekana pale Nyanza akiapiga some of the things ama some of the sentiments which are made by our current DP. Kuna uwezekano wa kukua na division hapa kwa sababu pia Rigathi anasema upande ule mwingine wameshikana sako kwa bako.
Okay, I think maybe if you try to interpret or analyze the things that have happened, ningesema ya kwamba wenye wanasema hivyo wanaweza kuwa na sababu yao, what you call the perspective, ile kitu wameona. But ni vizuri wakumbuke constitutionally, the president, once you become the president, you are no longer a politician for one side, right? Yeah, you become the symbol of national unity. Now, the deputy president, who happens to be the deputy party leader of the UDA, now takes the mount of politics, right? So, and I think there's a video that we did and I said, Gachagua, when Ruto became the president, now Gachagua became the political president of the UDA party. So you'll find most of the times Gachagua talking about issues or the issues concerning the UDA party. And I think what he said, it is not the wrong thing. It is what have been happening traditionally in most of the government. The only problem Gachagua did is that he made it so vocal, so public. But if you look at the government that of Mwai Kibaki, you look at the government of Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, the region that the leaders came from benefited most, right? From that regime. But that's not what should happen. That one should not be the case. And that's why the president went to Nyanza, he said that no one will be discriminated based of where they voted. Because now when you come into power, it means the manifesto that you sold, because we are a democracy, we are a republic, right? So the majority wins, they have their way, the minority, right?
Have their say.
So now, because the majority have their way, it means that now the president will implement the manifesto that he promised Kenyans, not only for those who elected him, but the whole nation, because now he becomes the father of the nation. That's why he becomes the symbol of nationality. So I think Gachagua, the only thing he need to do, he need to know what to say at what particular time, because now, the season we are in, when you start talking about shares, the government belongs to shares, and you try to look at where we are coming from. We are coming from Maandamano, we are coming from people who are saying the election was stolen, there are people who are saying that they are not included in the government. So as a wise politician, you may know that is the case, but you don't say it. You keep it for yourself and you do it slowly. But I think that's what the problem is, because when the president say that, that is petty politics, that is pettiness. That's what he is right to say that, because constitutionally where he stand, he's the father of the nation. He doesn't have to discriminate any son or daughter. Mm. Yes.
So DP is on record. Mm-hmm. Akisema ya kwamba mlima ulipatiana 47%
yes,
ya kura za pale Kenya Kwanza.
Yes.
Na he's so dedicated that ata make ikue at least ata kama si 100 ilikuwa 87% mm-hmm. 47% ni shareholding kwa Kenya Kwanza government. Mm-hmm. Na pia kuna hiyo 13% mm-hmm. yenye hawakupata 2022 mm-hmm. kuna likelihood wataipata 2027 uh-huh. ama bado itapugua kulingana na vile maneno iko mm-hmm. unajua maneno kwa ground ni tough sana
mm-hmm. I think Mount Kenya as a region we have a long way to go because you see the problem we are in is that William Ruto as the president and also as the party leader of UDA seem to have a lot of say in Mount Kenya region than Gachagua or than any other politician in the Mount Kenya region. So he can be able to do away with Gachagua. Don't forget that. It is not Gachagua, and Kenyans allow me to take you back a little bit. Look at how we came up with Jubilee. Ruto came up with URP and Uhuru came up with TNA. So there are two people almost with equal strength that combined their efforts. That's how they formed Jubilee. The case of 2022 was very different. Mm-hmm. Gachagua was hard-picked mm-hmm. by Ruto. Yes. In fact, he was appointed. You see now, because the one who invested politically in Mount Kenya region more was Ruto, and he had no equal partner who could bargain anything about Mount Kenya, yes, on his government. That's why it is easy for him to sidelining Gachagua. If Gachagua would have to get the mantle, to get the strength, to be able to come, to sit almost at the same table with the likes of Mudavadi, the likes of Wetangula, those who are political parties, he need to ensure that he have solidified the Mount Kenya region. And what he need to do, from where I sit, he first of all needs to avoid any fight with any politician from the region. There are people who are very influential, the likes of Maina Jenga, the likes of Riki Nyanjui, the likes of Martha Karua, the likes of Sabina Chege, the likes of Kanini Kega. Those people, they have their foreign. And if he is able to convince all of these politicians to come back and be under one umbrella, it will be so easier for him. Because look at what is happening now. Gachagua is being fought in the country, also via social media. But have you seen any politician from Kiambu defend Gachagua? Mm-hmm. Have you seen any politician from Laikipia defend Gachagua? Have you seen any politician from Meru defend Gachagua? Have you seen anyone from Muranga? No. So that tells you he's only isolated to Nyeri. The only people I've seen the talk is Governor Mutahika Kahiga and some few people from Nyeri. So I think that's a red signal, a red flag for him to know that the people are not feeling the weight of. He still have a long way to instill himself as the voice or as the spokesman of Mount Kenya. So I think he have a long way to go if he's going to unite Mount Kenya mm. and get that 13%. But it is very possible. Mm-hmm. You see, the psychology of voting in Mount Kenya region is very easy. We are emotional people. We never vote from point of logic. We voted because of the propaganda that was sold here. So I think if it's the right moment now, the way people are saying, oh, we need Uhuru, Ruto is discriminating Mount Kenya region, it's like he have a plan to do away with Mount Kenya region. Mm-hmm. It's time now to hit the nail when it is still hot. You hit now so that now everybody who's feeling that, like, you know what, we may have made a wrong decision, let's now come back, be in one house and then decide our fate. So I think that's the best best we can do now.
Okay.
Yes.
Tunaweza enda ile side ya Gathoni wa Moshoba, MP Githunguri. Anaonekana ni kama anaongea the voice of the people. Anakumbuka nilikuwa pale Ruiru Stadium on Sunday. Na akasema ya kwamba si kila wakati that wananchi watakuwa wanakaa ni kama wanaomba serikali wasaidie na hii na walichaguana. They must be demanding now services to be done. Na anaonekana though alichaguliwa na hii serikali ya Kenya Kwanza, bado anaenda against the serikali ya Kwanza. Pia tuliona Sabina Chege aliruzi ile kiti yake. So are we expecting some pale MP wa Githunguri apate some vuta ni kuvute kwa sababu yeye anaenda against chama?
You see, in politics your currency to power is people. And I must tell you, Gathoni wa Moshoba moves are very, very strategic. And if, at the end of it, she will win. Yes, because she is talking the voice of the people. She's the only person speaking. And whatever she is saying, people can resonate with her. People can understand what she is saying. Like when she was speaking about Mumia Sugar and also these sugar companies from Western being given 117 billion, and yet the coffee farmers are only requesting for 6 billion, and the government cannot be able to give them, but it can give 117 billion to that region. It tells you when he speaks that language, he's speaking to who? The coffee farmers or the farmers from Kenya, who are the majority and who voted to this government. But remember, you had Deputy President Gachagua, who had promised to fight to ensure that he fight until kahawa and farmers, milk and tea get enjoy their hard work. But you see, Gachagua is not saying the same thing. That the cabinet that passed that bill, Gachagua was in that cabinet, right? What did he say about the farmers? So we have not received anything he said contrary to what the cabinet passed, but we have now what Wa Moshoba is saying. So Wa Moshoba is representing the people from the region, and I think if you look at the reception of what he said and also what Maina Jenga was saying in Ruiru, it can tell you people are starting to sense a sense of, although not so clear, a sense of betrayal from there, from the KK regime. And it is so early, and it can be so destructive to the current regime if that path is not, if they don't watch out. Yes, yes.
So nilikuwa nataka pia uguzie ziara ya rais pale Nyanza, Homa Bay, Kisumu. Alionekana pia akienda pale, our president is very wise. Na kuna vile alikuwa anacheza na ground vizuri. Na ground hajakuwa hostile pale. Akawaambia maandamano haina manufaa. Pia kuna investors wanafaa wakuja hapa. So generally, hiyo ziara yake ulionaje?
I think it was very successful. Very very successful indeed. The reception was very heroic. Indeed, majority did not expect that. But we also have to thank Bamba, because he allowed the governors and also leaders from those regions to attend. He gave them the permission. And I think I had watched an interview he did with KTN News. I think two days before Ruto went to that region. And he said, because it is developmental, and Ruto is not going there as a politician, he's going there as a president. So he had allowed the governors, the leaders from that region to be part of those meetings. So I think they have been successful, and we need to see this more and more, because it is not season for politics. Because if they don't allow Ruto to go to those regions, who loses? Are they the politician or are they the people? The manager will be the one to lose. So I think it is very, very wise that sometimes we keep politics aside and we allow development, because that is the key. Every government that comes to power comes with a manifesto. That manifesto is not for the sake of the politician. That manifesto is for the sake of the people. So I think it's good that we allow, sometimes we keep the politics aside and we allow development to take the lead.
Haya, turudi hapa Mount Kenya region kidogo tu. Kulikuwa na main conference pale Kimoroli Ground.
Yes.
Na ilikuwa very successful. Na kulikuwa na resolutions mingi ziliwekwa pale na our leaders, wa Goko na Maina Jenga.
Yes, yes.
Hawa watu wako na usemi gani out Kenya region?
I think if you look at the turnout of that meeting, it tells you that these are people that you cannot underrate. They have an influence. They have an influence. They have people who, when they speak, they hear. When they make a call, they respond. When they make a request, they have people who can actually do what have been requested to do. So I think politically is a plus. Also as a region is a plus. Because you see, when the young people start getting united, the way you saw there, is not wrong. The only thing that must be taken care of and must be addressed very, very well and clearly is the issue of this young people, because the issue would come when you have gathered these young people, but you don't have a direction of where you are taking them, right? And that's why they turn up to be misused by the politician. So I think looking at what happened in Kimorori is a good thing. One of the reasons that they made is people need to get more children, which I agree with. Because
watano watano,
we agree, because you look at, but if you go through the most of the public school where we schooled, see, to request streams come and ne. Right? So I think it was a good reason. Too, they are talking about Mount Kenya unity, which is very key. At this particular time, the thing tunasemanga in Greek tunasema, kamugiko yaga ke?
Goya adere.
Kamugiko yaga adere. Nagutire, te jabaonerehi nyate ya, degehigiridia irioko e wiki. Right, so we need to come together. We need to fight for our issues together. Remember the issues of boundary coming, right? Next year, there are constituencies like Madioya, Kangema, Odhaya, Mukuraine, that they have been listed as to be Odorewa. So we need to fight for this constituency and that the issue of one man, one vote, one sharing. So I think we have a lot to do, and this thing can only be achieved if we go as one team, as one region, as one people.
Haya, yes, we wind up. Maina Kamunya. Reshuffle ilifanyika pale ya cabinet. Moses Kuria akasema kuna watu watajiharia. Anyway, tunampenda sana CS Moses Kuria.
Yes, my friend.
So, kuna watu waliona kama Mudavadi ameongezewa powers kuliko Washagua. Kuna wengine wakasikia ya kwamba maybe yule hakupelekwa pahali pazuri, mwingine hakupewa time enough. Ulichukuliaje?
The shuffle was done, but I think as majority of Kenya would say, I think there are people, Musalia gained a lot, but a person like Moses Kuria lost. Because and I think it was a political. It's more political than any other reason that could be given. Because you look at how Moses Kuria had been able to do it in those 11 counties that he had attended. If he was able to do that for the other 47 counties, for all the 47 counties, by the time he was to be done with them, he would have gained a very, very good name. But you see, there are people who fear. The way he said it is true. There are people who maybe fear, because you need to understand who is Moses Kuria. Moses Kuria is this one, very intelligent
ground mobilizer.
Very intelligent ground mobilizer, but also can be very stupid. Right? He is very wise and very intelligent, but if you want him to be stupid, he can be very stupid. He is also very, very strategic. He knows what he wanted to achieve. And never ever underrate Moses Kuria. When it comes to politics, don't underrate Moses Kuria. He is able to play cards in a very wise way, that by the time you're coming to realize what he's trying to do, it is too late for you. If you look at the narrative that started in Mount Kenya region, it was 31st time where Dika alisema si tunaletewa hasira wale wanaletewa maendeleo, and you look at how that narrative shaped the UDA politics in Mount Kenya region. So Kuria is very wise, Kuria is very intelligent, but I think he was being tamed, because if he was able to do that thing for the 47 counties, he would have built a very good network, resources, and people would, because people wanted to feel the presence of the government on the ground. And he is able to resonate with the people. He's able to do all that which people are required. So I think it was more political, but I think, but if even that position he had been given, Kuria is able to work. His intelligence, he knows how to maneuver. He will maneuver until he still make an impact. So I think my friend Moses Kuria, I want to wish you all the best. Don't worry, fight these battles. You are used to these battles. Fight them, and we are guaranteed that you'll be able to achieve your agenda. He's a performer. Yes, he's a performer.
koti ilisimamisha maneno ya soldiers kupelekwa pale Haiti, mm-hmm. na pia tuliona watu wa Haiti mm-hmm. wakiquestion our president William Samoei Ruto wakisema ya kwamba yeye ni US puppet. Mm-hmm. Nataka uguzie hiyo maneno mm-hmm. na pia uguzie maneno ya pale Israel mm-hmm. kuna vita na inaendelea pale. Mm-hmm. Kumbuka pale Haiti US mm-hmm. yenyewe ishajaribu kuingia pale mm-hmm. wakaona cha mtema kuni. Mm-hmm. Watoto wetu wakienda pale watatoboa. Na kwa nini sisi tupeleke watu wetu pale na US ingepeleka tu inapeana tu pesa?
I think I would agree with the majority of Kenyans. There is no solid reason given as to why you would travel so all those miles mm-hmm. to take our soldiers from this region all the way to North America. I think it doesn't make any sense. Two, if you look at the countries that are surrounding that, the Haiti, they are far way superior in terms of intelligence, in terms of weapons, more than us. USA, so they have the best and the most sophisticated weapons, right? So why would you take Kenyans? So I think it is, there are some hidden interest, probably, that we don't know. We don't know maybe what we'll discuss, because as many could say, mm-hmm. Why not any other country other than Kenya? Is Ruto trying to sell our Kenyan soldiers for his own interest or for the sake of a good reputation, for a good name? Because remember, Ruto have been on, if you look at since he was elected, he has been on the move trying to portray himself as that voice of Africa, mm-hmm. right? So if he's able to attract the US and the US have his attention, then it will be so easier for him to be that voice, to be the link between the US and Africa. But I think it may not work well with the majority of the African president, bearing in mind what is happening. If you look at especially the Western region, the Burkina Faso, Mali, they no longer feel the presence of the colonizers. They want to be free. They want to be liberated. They want to work and give themselves dignity as a nation. So I think if we make this move, and maybe majority of our soldiers die, because those who can remember about Kismayo, we lost so many soldiers before they were able to stabilize and be able to fight the war. So I think I would agree with the court that it is not the right move until a solid decision or a solid reason is given. I think we should abscond that mission.
Haya, kuna watu wetu wako pale Israel mm-hmm. na kuna vita inaendelea hapo mm-hmm. Sasa sijui, unajua ile maneno ya Russia na Ukraine ilifanya maneno huku ziharibike sana uchumi wa Kenya mm-hmm. Sijui ile vita itatu affect aje kama nchi.
Of course it will affect us, because there are so many things that we import from Israel, especially ni hizi, I think ni garlic, onion mashungwa, mm-hmm. oranges. Some of them come from that nation, and you see when there's war in a nation, mm-hmm. they give their priority to their people. You can't export food when you know there's a war in a nation, so you reserve the food for the sake of your population. So I think it will, of course, it will have an impact on other nations, especially those that depend from Israel for food, for real food. But globally, I say that any part of the world that experience war, they must have a global impact.
Asante sana. Yes. So asante sana. Uh-huh. Next time nikikupata bado utakuja tuzungumze pamoja. Mm-hmm. Na thank you for always finding time to come to our channel mm-hmm. na kutu advise hapa na pale. We don't take it for granted. Na tukitoka hapa leo na nitanunua kitu. Unakunywaga nini?
Kinipea Dero Monte ya passion, I'll be fine.
Sawa, yeah. Ubaya ni ati huku kumejaa hapo. Asante sana. Until next time, I was your host, Mheshimiwa Bendawa.